So, should you leave your puppy to cry out when you first bring them home? This is a question that comes up a lot in the Facebook group. And it's one of those things that people can unintentionally get it wrong with, because what we often believe is we should let them cry it out. We bring a puppy home, they just need to learn that if they cry, no one is going to arrive. But we now know this is not accurate information. We now know if we leave a puppy to cry it out, we not only increase their chances of getting stressed when they're alone, but we also decrease their chances of actually resting and sleeping. We want your puppies to feel secure. You know, your puppy has just come away from their mum and their siblings and their lovely house that they've lived in for their whole life, and simply expecting them to sleep downstairs while you're upstairs for the whole night is likely to result in failure for most dogs. Instead, what you want to be doing is setting them up for success and building up your absences gradually. Your puppy will become confident with you leaving them if they get used to the idea you will be there for them if they need you. So very often the best suggestion is, if you would like your puppy to sleep downstairs in the long run, you have the crate downstairs or their little sleeping area, and you sleep nearby to that. So that might be that you sleep on the sofa, that might be you're sleeping somewhere in the same room as them, but you're staying there for at least the first week, I'm afraid. If they need to go out in the night, you take them out to pee. If they whimper or anything, you can put your hand through the bars, but often at this age, they need the toilet, so you need to be taking them out for that. Now, if they are getting the hang of that, you then start to gradually move away from them at night. It might be that you just halfway through the night slip out and go upstairs, or it might be that you sleep further away from them in the same space and then you gradually move upstairs. Maybe keeping a routine of the time of night you take them out to the toilet, if you're taking them out in the night, so that they're clear on when you will arrive and when they will go back to sleep. The other alternative is, if you want them in your room and you want them crated, often is the easiest option if you are happy with that, is to have the crate nearby you and do the same sort of thing. If you want to stay in your bed, you can have them in the crate near you, put your hands through if they're getting anxious, take them out to the toilet when they need it. It could be that you don't want them in the crate in the long run, in your room, you want them to eventually go downstairs, and that's also fine. What you can start to do is move the crate away from you in your bedroom and then into the hallway and gradually downstairs. It does tend to be a process. It's not going to happen literally overnight. And some puppies do go a bit of up and down with it. If they are getting distressed and they're anxious, you should be going to them. You're not reinforcing any, what like old school trainers call, attention seeking, because they're not seeking attention in the sense of they just want you to come and play with them. They're yelping or whimpering or crying because they need you, because they're scared. And if you go to them when they're scared and you give them that reassurance and you take them out to pee, they tend to, in the long run, be a lot happier, because they know that if they do need something, someone is there for them. Just Arkle trying to walk in front of the camera there. What are you doing? He doesn't know. So just a quick one on that. I thought I'd make this video because it comes up quite a lot. If your puppy is crying in the night, it's not attention seeking. Don't leave them to cry out. This can be massively damaging to your puppy and lead to other problems later. Be prepared for some sleepless nights when you get your puppy, and make sure you're there for them. Don't get mad at them, and be aware it might take some time. If you need any additional support, you can get in touch, and we can always do one-to-ones or anything similar if you require that tailored support. But otherwise, remember, they're just a puppy, they're just scared, and give them that time to get used to being around you, get used to knowing you, and set them up for success with a good bedtime routine with where they're going to sleep and you phasing out your presence if you want to. If you want them to sleep in your room, also, that's absolutely fine.